Nowadays lots of thought is going on the non-HDL cholesterol. So what are your thoughts on the non-HDL cholesterol, and do you think that it is a better parameter for the severe risk assessment than the LDL cholesterol?
This is a good question that you have raised now. Atherosclerosis is a preventable disorder. LDL cholesterol plays a major role not only in the initiation of atherosclerosis but also in the progression of atherosclerosis, ending in clinical cardiovascular events. We have been depending mainly on LDL cholesterol all these days. The robust evidence actually comes from the statin trials, which had shown more the reduction of LDL cholesterol, the more benefit that we have reached in getting a cardiovascular risk reduction, and not only in morbidity but also in mortality. But if you go into the depth of the details of atherosclerotic process or the pathogenesis, you will be surprised to see that about 75% contribution is made only by your LDL. The remaining things are actually constituted by the triglyceride-rich lipoprotein particles, like IDL or a VLDL cholesterol. In fact, the triglyceride-rich particles are elevated whenever there is an hypertriglyceridemia. In fact, the VLDL plays a major role in the atherogenesis. The VLDL cholesterol, apart from its remnants, play a major role in initiating the endothelial dysfunction along with the LDL also. So we need not forget the role of VLDL, the role of IDL, the role of chylomicron remnants. In fact, if you look at all the parameters of atherosclerotic lipid involvement, you leave the HDL cholesterol, which is anti-atherogenic, which has got an ApoA moiety. Rest of the things are all atherogenic particles, which also includes your LDL, includes your IDL, VLDL, chylomicron remnants, lipoprotein little e. You put everything in a basket and call that as a non-HDL, that is appropriate. So in fact, correctly speaking, I think if you are able to concentrate on non-HDL cholesterol, you are not only covering the LDL, but also other atherogenic particles, so that the overall prediction of cardiovascular risk due to lipids probably will be seen.
Right, sir. So, sir, as you rightly said, non-HDL cholesterol is a better parameter than the LDL cholesterol. So, sir, what are the evidences available to support this statement?
In fact, there are huge number of studies like Nurses' Cell study, Women Hull study, Framingham Half-Swing study, and then the multiple risk factor intervention trials and the lipid research clinic programs. All those trials have shown consistently that non-HDL has got a greater risk of future cardiovascular events than compared to the LDL cholesterol. In fact, there's a huge meta-analysis which was done, again started emphasizing the role of non-HDL when compared to LDL. I can only quote one meta-analysis which had included the latest trials in lipid management, like 8 trials, 62,000 patients. The conclusion in that particular trial is HDL is a good parameter when compared to LDL, number one. And they had analyzed the hazard ratio for people who had already reached the LDL cholesterol goal of 100, but still their non-HDL cholesterol is about 130. Their risk of developing a cardiovascular disease is about 32%. Whereas people who are still keeping the levels of LDL more than 100, but their non-HDL cholesterol is then 130, the risk of getting a cardiovascular event is only 1.02 hazard ratio, indicating only 2% chances. It again emphasizes that we need to concentrate on non-HDL, which is probably the correct parameter which will identify people who are going to get cardiovascular problems. It is also true in people who had received statin, and in spite of the fact that they received adequate dose of statin, there remains a residual risk. The residual risk probably will be only identified if you are going to implement the introduction of non-HDL as a parameter, so that we will cover and try to bring down the cardiovascular risk.
Right, sir. So, sir, based on the available data, which is in obviously in favor of the non-HDL cholesterol, are there any recommendations in the international dyslipidemia management guidelines?
I can quote any number of recommendations. The first recommendation that has come to start is that the International Atherosclerosis Society, which has started talking about the non-HDL. We need to concentrate on atherogenic cholesterol, which includes LDL and non-HDL. Non-HDL is nothing but the LDL plus VLDL. You need to concentrate on that, and it is equal to the ApoB. It is better when compared to LDL. That's a recommendation by International Atherosclerosis Society. Whereas the NLA, National Lipid Association, has come out saying that non-HDL is a better parameter when compared to LDL, based on the evidence. Again, they say observational study, the study which has shown the lipid reduction by using statins, had consistently shown that non-HDL cholesterol is a better parameter. Again, this has gained a lot of importance even by the ACC-AHA guideline, which had released the recommendation in 2016. The entire scenario of their approach, which was predicted in the beginning in 2013, completely got changed in 2016. They had given importance non-HDL cholesterol has to be identified as one of the risk parameter in people at least with diabetes, with metabolic syndrome, or people who are obese or with insulin resistance.
Right, sir. So, sir, finally, what will be the final key message to the practitioners?
Now, as far as India is concerned, I think we are encountering a problem of a high triglyceride, low HDL, atherogenic dyslipidemia, most of the problems of obesity, metabolic syndrome, and diabetes. If you take all this in consideration along with the lipid parameters, I think ideally we need to probably concentrate on non-HDL rather than the LDL cholesterol. If you concentrate on non-HDL, you are almost, it subsumes the impact created by triglyceride particles. You need not concentrate triglycerides separately. If you are going to concentrate on non-HDL, probably that will cover the entire atherogenicity of the lipoprotein molecules, which will probably have an impact in endothelium, which will have an impact in atherosclerotic volume increase.